Okay, evidently this is going to be like about a 4 or 5 video step here. This is a collection of pots and pans, planters for probably about 3 to 4 years, because you can't afford, I mean, I actually couldn't afford it. I could get 2, maybe 3, and that's it, and then 2 or 3, and if anybody had any, I've used them. Okay, but this year I'm a little different. My wife was talking about putting some gravel in the bottom of the pots to aerate it a little bit more. I didn't think about that before, but I did that to that little one right there. I put some topsoil that was in another planter in there from last year. It should be okay. I'm going to put fresh topsoil with it. But you can see I put just a little bit of gravel in all of the planters. And then these here, I just got out and I got this ice cream bucket we use. We don't eat ice cream much, but when we do, we get this tub of, you know, a gallon, and that's our treat for a month, if we get it. But I go out there and get a couple handfuls of that. I get like 10 handfuls. And then I got big rocks. I got some little ones. And the bigger ones, I'm going to use as bigger planters. There's some little rocks in here, too, I got in the other planters. But the big rocks are going to go in the bigger planters as much as possible on the bottom. Okay, you just want to, don't even have to cover the whole bottom, but the majority of it. You know, something like that right there. Okay, and then you put your potting soil on top of that. This was on sale at Hyphenex, which is supposed to be pretty good. I didn't look at it. I kept saying, for $1.74 for 20 quarts, I'm thinking to myself, that's really cheap. It's usually about almost $3. And I, first thing, my mind goes to Fukushima, and I want to see if this is a product of Japan or not, which would just be, you know, par for the course, actually. I got a great shears, pruners, and I got some newspaper I had out in the shed here that got wet because the shed leaks. Let that dry out, because that goes in the bottom of those toilet paper roll holders. So let me do that one right here. Oh, just a damn shoot. Yeah, you don't want to do this with a camera in your hand because, see, I have 2 hands, man. Oh, I just ripped it open. Tracy! I have to get my wife out here now. Bring the tripod! Bring the tripod out here, please. I'm trying to do this with one hand and open up. The bag ripped open on me, so I'm still recording because I don't want to keep cutting the tape short for the video. But, alright, let's stay like that. Oh. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, don't hit that bag. Thank you. Shoot, now that wind better not blow that over. That'll piss me off. So it's still recording. I don't want to stop and start because I got stuff on here and then I want to stop and start all over again. Usually have this by the door so we can get to it right away. All right, now let me turn this a little bit. Of course, it's at the very bottom. Let me flip another bag over here, maybe. See if I can see it. Get this bag open. Start it off. Okay, right there. All right. With the brightness out here on the screen, I can't really focus good if I can see it. Okay, it's packaged by Hyphenex. Maryville, Ohio. But it doesn't say the origin of it, though. That's the thing that gets me. Try that www. ScottsCompany.com. Let's see if I can find out where they get the soil from. For $1.79 for a 20-quart bag, it's really cheap. So I got 3 bags. Should be more than enough, but you know, might need another bag of dollars. But that'll get me for this pot here. 6. 6 of the larger ones. And then 1 that green one. Four of those, about the quart size. And I have a bunch of these. These would be pint size. I don't know how many, whatever the general thing is, we buy the tray. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. 17 is 38. 40. There's about 50 of those. So, these are ones that we bought last year too. We used some of them. This is where you put the soil in this, and then you just put it inside the ground. See, it has to be in something because the water leaks through it. So foil. Or that tray here, I'm going to use a tray if I can. It's made for the orange plastic squares. So, that's that. I just want to get the applying soil so you can see what I did with put the rocks in the bottom and the applying soil on top. So it'll have aeration at the bottom. And I'll just mix some of the new stuff in with this old. I might take some of that out of that little quart one there and mix that with another one into a new pot planter. Duh. So, okay, this is the third video, and I think maybe one more when I do the seeds.